funding. You need resources, you need funding, and they invested heavily. They recruited players from all across the park, brought them down there into St. Anne, and they got into the semi-finals. Well, they were using the goal to the left of the screen for the penalty shootout, we're told, and Barbican will be kicking first.
One of the things that I tried to follow up on the points that you made earlier, but one of the things with the Mount Pleasant team is that having resources, yes, and the extent to which they were able to go into this market and bring players, I'm not too certain that they are satisfied with the end result. And that is probably something that you have to ponder over too.
Yeah. So we are at the penalty shootout now to decide this grand finale. Leon Taylor will be in the goal first. Former Lions United. And Barbican will kick first. It's going to be Andrew Christie to kick for Barbican. He had a double in open play in the semi-final. He came into this match with 4 goals to his tally. Let's see if he can open the scoring now for Barbican in this penalty shootout.
Must be very confident though, given his propensity in scoring goals.
It's going to be Andrew Christie of Barbican against Leon Taylor of Malines United. First kick in this penalty shootout. Andrew Christie is ready. Christie finds a target quite efficiently. Puts Barbican into the early ascendancy.
A quality strike went into the stanch and the back stanch, and the goalkeeper usually doesn't have too much of a chance when it goes that close to the upright. So Barbican moves first, takes the first step, scores the first goal, and already put Malines under some pressure.
Ronaldo Smith now will step up to the plate for Malines United. Let's see if he can reply immediately. It's Ronaldo Smith now. It's right footed all along the surface. Yes, it's there. One apiece.
Almost exactly like the previous penalty where it went into the stanchion, which is a support bar that's behind the goal. Goalkeepers usually don't have too much chances unless they would have positioned themselves knowing beforehand where the kicker is likely to go.
The substitute, Maurice Wilson, steps up now. It's 1-1 in the penalty shootout after the first set of kicks. Maurice Wilson for Barbican. Can he put them up 2-1? In this drama, it's Wilson. Oh, that was cool. It was calm. It was collective. Minimum fuss. No ache, no pain. Barbican go out front 2-1.
I thought the goalkeeper there misjudged. You know, there is a cardinal rule. Don't move until the kicker takes it. He went to his right, and Wilson just went to the direction that he was moving away from. Didn't give him a chance unless he had the ability to turn in the air.
Patrick Chiklou now to take his chances for Malines United and keep them on even keel. Barbican lead it 2-1.
And if he scores, he called the score.
Chiklou for Malines United.
Left footer apart.
after the first four kicks in the contest.
One, two kicks to the right, two kicks to the left.
Let's see what Joel Nicholas will choose to do now. Even in the penalty shootout, the deadlock exists. Nicholas for Barbican. Oh, it's safe! Leon Taylor coming up big for Manchester United. How critical will that be?
We will know in a short while. Too close to the keeper. He didn't have too much to do. It was like, you know, a yard from where he was standing, so he just stuck his right hand out and was able to stop it.
Now then, it's Tyreek Sutherland to the spot for Leeds United. He had a fairly decent performance in regulation and extra time. Let's see if he can cap that off now from the 12-yard spot. Tyreek Sutherland, former Leeds United. It's Sutherland. Yes, it's there. Low and flat. 3-2 to Leeds United. They have their noses in front now.
But if you notice, Spencer, what they have, both teams would have done was go right, then left, then right again. So that's how they have set up their kickers. Unfortunately, for the Barbican team, the goalkeeper was able to get a hand to the shot from their kicker.
The super sub, Tashi Dixon, steps up now for Barbican, and he has got to score this to keep his team in contention. If he misses, Barbican will be staring down the barrel. Must score this to keep them in the contest. Tashi Dixon. Can he win it all for Leeds United?